Today we learn how we can create game in MIT App Inventor. So we are going to learn here how we can create Octopus game. So as you can see here, what I have done, let me just go through this all app, all coding and everything. I'm gonna explain you, okay, one by one. So as you can see here, that's the app here. And what I have done, I have created one vertical arrangement. I have created one screen and just drag and drop one vertical arrangement. And in that vertical arrangement, I have just added one button. This is the button. And I have just changed that text name. That is the start game. Then I have just hide this vertical arrangement and just created another vertical arrangement. And it's look like this. And in this arrangement, I have just added one label. This is called game over and one reset button. Okay, like this. And one thing, I have added one more label to make some space here. Okay, now. As you can see, this is our game over screen and just hide this. Now I have added one more canvas. Okay, I just added only one canvas and make it enabled. So as you can see here in this canvas, I have just changed that canvas background color to black and I have added the 4-5 image spread. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4 and there's one octopus image. You can make a sound also whenever we click on the octopus or something. You can use the sound effect also in this game. So once we click on this, so we will do the coding. So as you can see here, that's the overall design. Okay, now as you can see here, I have added one ball also. See this one ball, and you can make it visible on like this. So this will visible on right now, this one. Okay, so make sure this should be visible off like this. Okay, and this should be here, or image spread. So we have 5 image spread, 1 ball. Okay, done. So that is the design part. So what you need to do, you need to first of all, you need to create all these screens first. Okay, 3 means canvas, then vertical arrangement 2 and vertical arrangement 1. And make sure you have to hide canvas. Okay, make sure visual should be off. Make sure visual vertical arrangement 2 should be off. Okay, and 1 only should be displayed like this. Now let's go to the coding part. Let's go. Now as you can see here, very basic coding is simple is like whenever we click on the button 1, so make sure the vertical arrangement 1 should be visible false and the canvas should be true. Okay, now what will happen in the canvas? So as you can see here, whenever you touch the image sprite, so which is the image sprite? So once I click on this button, so automatically this will hide. Okay, and this will display canvas like this. Now whenever I click on this, as you can see image spread 1, so once I click on this image spread, so as you can see here, the set ball visual should be true. We already have hide one ball here, right, this one. So make sure this visual should be true. And then point direction, it means the ball point direction goes in which direction the ball should go. So the ball direction should be random. Okay, random integer. As you can see, I have added the one random integer method here, 1 to 400 and 1 to 400. So it can get the x and y value from 1 to 400. Okay, and then ball dot speed is equal to the 10 because we have to move our ball. So make sure that speed we have to add. So I have just added the 10 speed here. So the ball will start moving in the random position. Okay, now what will happen here? What we will do, we will use here one initialize global. We will create one simple variable and we will assign the 0 value. Okay, now what we need to do, we need to just figure it out how we can make this game over and how we can get the score, how we can win or lose. So as you can see here, this is the method we will write. Then when the ball collide with, okay, if the ball collide with other, if the image sprite is not equal, then to get other, it means whenever the ball one collide with anyone, okay, it this one ball, right, this one, and this collide with anyone, it means that can collide with this image sprite itself, right? But we are not going to get a score from this. Okay, so what I will do, if the image spread not is equal to the 1, then we need to set the score. It means whenever the ball collide with any image spread, then we will get one score, global score. As you can see, the value is 0. And then make sure that image spread, okay, whatever the image spread will, you know, collide with the ball, so that image spread should be visible off. As you can see, that defined. Then now when the ball reach the edge, okay, if the ball reach the edge of the screen, okay, this one, then we need to set our ball speed should be 0. Then we have to move ball to the xy position. This is the center position of the ball. Okay, and as you can see, the ball should be visible false. Yes. and make sure we have to display the game overlay or game over layout, and this is our vertical arrangement too, right? That's one, and that dot visible should be true and canvas should be false. Now we have to add one simple condition: if the global score is greater than 2, or you can make it greater than 4 or something, if you will make it 4 like this, or you can make it 3 something, then the level 3 should be right, like you win, otherwise that should be loss. Okay, now as you can see here, on the button to click, what we have done, whenever we click on the button though, so which one is button 2? The button 2 is simple, button 2 is our this one, okay, vertical arrangement 2, it's the game over layout. So whenever we click on restart game, so make sure we have to hide the vertical arrangement 2, we need to enable the canvas, we need to make sure the image, all image sprite should be display again, because whenever the ball touch the image sprite, that is going to the we already have make them like visible or false. Okay, that's why whenever we restart the game, so make sure we have to enable all of them. So that's the very, very simple and amazing game. Okay, so what I will do, if you have any doubt, you can ask one command and I will give you that code also or file also in the description. I will make this game public. There's an option directly to the public. I will make it to the public. Okay. I will make this game public. Okay. So you can use that project. Okay. So I'll do that. I'll definitely do that. Okay. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye. And as you can see, this is the publish to gallery. This is the option directly. I will make it published, okay, immediately, and that project name is new project 22. Okay, so make sure this is new project 22. So yes, allow pop-up, done, publish to gallery, update project, and this is the Octopus game. Oh, it's necessary to fill the field description. Oh my god, it's necessary. So Octopus game credit the coding bus. Image file, no file, check if you want your app to be findable search. So make sure we have to provide the image. I will provide this one and let's try to submit. Let's see if this will work, then make sure, yeah, it's done. Okay, great. So let's try this and have a great day. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.